It is said that the battle is won before it is fought. Every day is a battle, and each day presents different set of problems to solve and situations to manage. Your greatest asset in this kind of situation is your mind. It is your greatest supporter. But if you do not tame your mind, it can be a liability and that would work against you. You need to program your mind to work for you. You need to teach your mind through constant practice to be disciplined, sharp, and focused. And you need to fill your mind with positivity. Prepare your mind to look forward to a great and fulfilling day. You would be a very sad person indeed if you go through life with your mind, which is meant to be your greatest supporter, turned against you. In order to be able to take control of your own mind and take advantage of its enormous positive benefits, listen to what I'm about to tell you and do it 5 or 6 days each week. You have to meditate. I am aware that it will sound unfamiliar to many people, and most people who attempt it will give up in a few days, a few weeks, or a few months. But don't be most people. The truth is that almost all of the richest and most famous and accomplished people in the world today do some kind of meditation almost every day of the week for a period of time. And the benefits of meditation are well documented. You will need to wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning each day. And for many people, they will need to start first by getting up 30 minutes to an hour before the time they currently wake up. Only then can they eventually get to the place where they can begin to possibly wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning. Now, I am aware that this will be very hard for some people. But as someone said, conviction and comfort don't live in the same block. And laziness and success are impossible roommates. If you do what is easy, your life will be hard. But if you do what is hard, your life will be easy. The truth is that waking up early gives you the upper hand in life. Getting up early gives you an advantage because most of your competitors would be sleeping by that time. But more importantly, it is one of the greatest gifts you can give to yourself. It has been found that the brain is sharper and more efficient between the early hours of 4 and 6. At this time, the mind is able to receive and absorb more facts and other data. When you have been able to do this, as you meditate, there are basically 3 things you need to do to start your day already a winner. Number 1, appreciation. You must show appreciation. Take some time to reflect on your life and write down the things you need to be appreciative for and the people to whom you should show gratitude. Make sure you not only think of them, but say them and if necessary and possible, write them down. If you must pray, do so. If it leads you to other actions in the day, so be it. Stop taking life for granted. Do not take the little things in life for granted. The second thing is read or listen to something. Anything that will add value to your life and help you with your development. It could be the Bible, any other book, a podcast, or an inspirational or educational material. Never miss an opportunity to learn something new each day. Learn something that will help you to become the person you want to be, a person that you are proud of. Finally, you have to exercise. Exercise regularly, and this will build both your body and your mind. There are so many different forms of exercise that you can go through. Many of those you wouldn't even need to leave your room to do them. Take 20 to 30 minutes and do some form of exercise each morning. This will energize you physically and mentally, and it will put you in the right frame of mind to start your day well and to enable you to deal with all the difficulties of the day with relative ease. 90% of success is just showing up and doing stuff. And what makes the difference is not giving up, especially when things don't go as smoothly as desired. It really doesn't matter much how talented or skillful you are. You could be very talented, you could be very intelligent and skillful, but if you are lazy, there is not much you can accomplish. Remember, you are not going to feel and be perfect every day. And so you should not want to do what needs to be done only when you feel good. Do it even when you don't feel very good. And desist from giving excuses, no matter how sound they may be, because at the end of the day, excuses will get nothing accomplished. Many people are counting on you. The world is waiting for you. Get it done because it is your duty. Get it done because you accepted to do it. Get it done because you very much know that it is you who has to do it. In short, do what needs to be done because it is good and because it must be done. And convince yourself that if it must be done, it must be done well. You decide what kind of day you want to have. You decide what ultimately defines your day. You do this through your own words, actions, and inaction, but also through your reactions to what happens around you, including the words, actions, and inaction of other people. There are those things you know very well are vital and need to be done if you must maintain your edge and keep winning. Make sure you get them done. No excuses, no complaints, just do it. People complain about how there is not enough time. Guess what? Jeff Bezos, founder and CEO of Amazon, and richest man in the world. Bill Gates, co-founder of Microsoft and the second richest person in the world. Mark Zuckerberg, co-founder of Facebook, among many others. All of them have one thing in common. They all have the same time as you, 24 hours in a day. But they are successful because they have discovered the value of time and how best to use the little time they have. If and when they deem it necessary, they are willing to create more time by foregoing some other not so important things. This is the kind of mentality and attitude you need to cultivate every single day in order to begin the day already a winner.